Hi, I'm Antonio Gustin, and I just want to say congratulations, because if you are watching this video and you have just gotten our new book, My Science Diary, that means that you have just taken the first steps to a lifelong pursuit of knowledge. And this could be the very moment where your career as a great scientist begins. Now, even if you don't grow up to be a great scientist, by the end of this video, you will know how to be a part of the greatest story ever told. The story of science.
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 Now, the story of science is our story. It is the story about how human beings went from living in caves to exploring the stars and understanding that both you and I are made of those stars. We are the cosmos made conscious. The story of science is our story, and it's still going.
And going.
And going.
And going.
And going.
So what is science, you ask?
Science is not a thing. It is not a body of knowledge, and scientists are not those guys.
Science is life. Science is everything.
Science is a way of thinking that helps us understand our existence and checking ourselves, separating what's real from what just makes us feel good.
It is a way of organizing our thoughts into a process and exercising our ability to reason and to think critically.
Now, we got to this part in our story by following a few simple guidelines and testing our ideas. And if you follow these guidelines, you too can be a part of the story of science. You can be a part of Science Club.
I look around and I see a lot of new faces out there. Some of you are watching for the very first time. That means that many of you are following the rules of science.
Yeah. Science.
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 Science. I see Science Club with some of the smartest boys and girls that have ever lived. I see all this potential. And I want to see this potential fulfilled. An entire generation with the potential to change the world. An entire generation that knows we are the cosmos made conscious, that we are made of stars. Free from superstition and false information, pseudoscience has no power over us, and true knowledge is ours to pursue. We are the greatest generation in history, full of curiosity, purpose, wonder. We look up at the night sky and we see our ancestors. And we know that we should go visit them. And we can do this together, each and every one of us, if we just follow the rules of Science Club. The first rule of Science Club is question everything and demand evidence. And the second rule of Science Club is question everything and demand evidence. No idea is true just because someone said so. Third rule of Science Club, question yourself. Where did your ideas come from? Did your cousin's neighbor's wife, mailman say so? Or did you test this idea for yourself? Just because you heard something is true doesn't make it true. Fourth rule of Science Club, test your ideas. Test them by the evidence gained from both observation and experiment. And if the evidence goes against what you thought was your idea might have to change. Fifth rule of Science Club, follow the evidence wherever it goes. And if you don't have evidence, keep an open mind. And the sixth and final rule of Science Club, remember, you could be wrong. every great scientist in history has been wrong about something. Scientists are just regular human beings, just like you, just like me, and all human beings make mistakes. Now, we do strengthen our ideas by the evidence gained from both observation and knowledge, but new evidence can always be introduced that changes things. Now, these are the six rules of Science Club, and I want to welcome you to a lifelong journey of knowledge.
Now, how do you become a great scientist, you might ask? Excellent question.
Anyone who follows these rules to explore their world and is curious is a great scientist.
Science is a way of thinking. Science is a verb. Science is a way of exercising evolution's greatest gift to us, our natural curiosity and our ability to reason. And when you science, the whole universe is yours to understand.
Science.
How do we begin to science, you ask? Excellent question.
Now, for those of us who are curious, the very first skill we need to develop is the skill of observation. Scientific observation is the base element of the scientific method or process. It is the core skill of every scientist to just make observations.
And this, my friends, is where my science diary comes in. My science diary is a book to record your observations. As Adam Savage once said, the only difference between screwing around and science
is writing it down. And that's where we're gonna begin, by writing down our observations.
My science diary is for you to record your observations in nature. The skill of observation is the very core of science, and anyone can do it. You can use this journal for anything you observe at any time of the year. Insects, frogs, weather, fungi, stars, and even people. The better you get at recording your observations, the better your information will be. The better your information is, the better the chances are that you will notice something that no one has ever noticed before. And that, my friends, is how you make a great discovery. Now here are some tips on making good observations. Now, to make good observations, you have to look closely and notice details. Make your observations as if you are on an alien planet.
Approaching unknown planet, prepare to explore and observe.
Pretend you're on a new world, seeing things that no one has ever seen before.
Oh my. Oh. I'm out.
Record all the details that you can think of for the next humans who visit this planet for the first time. Now, my science diary is already set up to help you be organized. There are points of data in it, like location, date, time, weather, phase of the moon. Now, you may develop a few more on your own, and that's perfectly okay. Use your senses. What did you see? What did you smell? What did you hear? How did it feel? And could you taste it? Be descriptive and be accurate. If you see something that is green, what kind of green was it? Was it a light green? Was it a dark green? Was it a spring green? And if you smelled something, describe the smell. Now record your thoughts, your insights, and be reflective.
Did you think of any questions in your observation or maybe have some concerns? Did your observation remind you of another observation that you've made in the past? And if so, what was the connection?
And most important of all, write down the questions that you think of.
Do frogs poop in the water?
Now this last part really was the most important of all. See, famous scientists throughout history are always known for making great discoveries, but great discoveries come after a great question. Now, as a species, humans have a natural genius for pattern recognition, but how we recognize those patterns is an individual gift that is dependent upon our experience and our interests. Now, some of us recognize patterns in mathematics, stars, puzzles, people, and and even words, among many other realms. Now, you may not know what your personal genius is, but that is something that we're going to discover together with this book, My Science Diary. Now, finding themes, patterns, and relationships in your observations is only the beginning.
Now, as your observation skills grow, you're going to think of possible explanations to the questions that you thought of. And these explanations
are called a hypothesis.
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 Now, a hypothesis is a possible explanation or prediction based on the observed data. But in order for a hypothesis to become a scientific hypothesis,
it must be tested. Now, no matter what idea that you are testing, the process remains the same.
And the process that we use to test a hypothesis is called
the scientific method. Now, we're not going to cover the scientific method until the next episode. But before we wrap up this video, I just wanted to tell you how excited I am that you have begun your journey into science. When you are scientifically literate,
your mind is on fire and you are in constant pursuit of knowledge.
And you may be young, but the world needs you now more than ever.
Your journey down this road may one day change the world. Change the world.
You never know. And if you think I'm exaggerating, if you think I'm being dramatic. Anyway, I just want to say thank you for watching this video, and I hope that you are as entertained as you were informed. And I really would like to congratulate you on your personal journey into science. But on a personal note, I would greatly appreciate it if you would like, comment, or share this video. This is how we get to produce the next episode on the scientific method. And if you would like to see that episode on the scientific method, subscribe. I'm Antonio Gustave, the Bug Whisperer, and I will see you in the next episode. Now go science!